Hello everyone. Greetings, I Hate League. Hope you're doing well this evening. Looks decent. So this is Twitchy Tuesdays, Seymour Goo. That's me. See if I can get some energy going. And So I checked these yesterday and there was like 3 weeks left on the one I stepped on, so I figured they were all 3 weeks left. It looks like somebody let two of them expire. Oops. Oh well. We shall deal. Anyway. Having a problem with the mouse. Because it feels like a carpal tunnel or flare up. My wrist is killing me. So, I have my brace on, which doesn't make for good mousing. Yay. What was I up to? Oh, what was I going to do? Oh yeah, these. So I need to do Grim Barrett, Subversion, and Tavern Brawl. And Crucible. This is really about all I wanted to do before I took the next level. So, looks like Hall of Heroes then. We'll see how those go. Excuse me. This might be exciting. Not sure. What's gonna go? Missing fire. Is it Sonic? Looks like it might be Sonic. Stone skin's probably a good idea. And also chat. I need to be able to see chat. Oh. Figure out that in a minute. For now.
Thank you.
Cat, you're not dying. No, you're not. I don't know what's up with him. I just went down to feed him before I started, and he's acting like he's hungry or something. He doesn't even look like he needs all his food. He's got water up here if he wants to drink it. He's got a box down there if he wants to go. I don't know. He's weird. Didn't survive that.
The combined power of all four wizards shatters the tiefling's magical barrier.
Check just because, yeah, I'm elite. The other day I thought I was an elite and I was on normal and I completely broke my bravery streak and I was so mad at myself. I realized it right at the end just after I'd completed. I was on the wrong difficulty. So by then it was already broken. He's alive in the room with me. That's dreadful. Thank you. I thought I'd switched my other stupid cloak already. The XP bonus, and I hadn't. I realized just about time he died, so I didn't get the bonus XP. It's really dumb. Lazy jerk. How are you with all your buddies dying? Legendary victory, yes, please. Let's see if I can get chat going. Hey, Cordovan, how's it going? Need to put the chat on top. There we go. Alright. Let's do Harper then. I mean, I need to bring out my handshake mouse. At least for work. So that automatic stun thing is pretty cool. I just picked that up. I am liking it. Spike. allowing me to get automatically stunned by my abilities without me having to do anything extra. I haven't run this quest very many times. So yeah, delayed blast will still hurt so much. For some reason, this reminds me of Dredger. Ooh, that was close. 12 hit points left. Kind of figured that might happen. But thought I'd have a little more room. Even if I didn't make the saves. Stop trying to backstab me, dude. Thank you. Oh, how I miss my warlock aura. I believe I'm gonna go back here and rest, get some of my charges stuff back. That seems like a good idea. And let's get some buffs going. Before I forget, do fire and sonic. It's nice to have those as backups. Oop. Yep, my mouse control with this stupid wrist brace is not what it needs to be for some of this stuff. I may have a shorter stream than I thought because of this wrist problem. That was a good one. Took out two of them.
As you enter the gatekeeper's stronghold, you spy a second gatekeeper portal in the corridor ahead.
Oh, treasure.
There's splinters of the shattered door drift down around you. The dire bear nods at the corridor ahead.
Yeah, let me do all the really dangerous stuff. That's cool. Did you study under Elminster or something? Dude, I got like a pack of Abishai. Can you not, you know, stop cleaning yourself in that? Give me a hand. Animal. It's like all my animals here at home. Nothing is more important than cleaning themselves. or feeding themselves or whatever they're doing at the moment. Let's go ahead and do this first. Survive the rest after a quick rest just to make sure I've got all my stuff up. I think the problem is that I have my mouse set to be really sensitive, and it usually fits right in the palm of my hand perfectly, and I've got this band in the way because of the brace, and it's not fitting like it normally does, so it's just not. Again, I forgot my cloak, so no bonus XPs from that, no drops. To the Hall of Heroes. Back to the ship, the Hall of Heroes. Let me find chat so I can actually read the comment. There? Yeah. So DestinyJulia89 asks if DDO is better than Sword Coast Legends, which should I get? Well, first of all, this is free and Sword Coast Legends isn't, so there you go. You can try DDO for free, and if you don't like it, that's cool, but at least you've tried it and you didn't spend any money on it. Sword Coast Legends is probably back to full price. Source Code's Legends is an isometric solo game. as Draculetta points out. Source Code of Legends has a bunch of community maps, and you can sort of multiplay up to four players. It has a completely different way to use. All your abilities are basically button clicks and time based, and you only have a couple of them active at once. The bar is limited, and I really didn't care for it. Our guild tried, three of us tried it, and two of us got refunds because we didn't think it was ready to go, and that was just before launch. So, Dracula is asking some good questions. You want an MMO, you want a solo game with a good story. The other thing I'll point out is DDO, all the quests have stories. Unlike a lot of MMOs where it's just fetch quests, all the quests have stories. There's a big overriding story, and different quests interweave storylines together. So it's unique in that aspect. The character creation is much more customizable in DDO versus Sword Coast Legends. Sword Coast Legends is very limited in the character creation and multiclassing and stuff. It was weak compared to DDO. Like their enhancement trees were pretty horrible from what I could, the little bit I played. I didn't really enjoy their enhancement trees at all. They're very generic. Whereas DDO has all this customization you can do in your enhancement trees and the different trees, the different abilities, things like Harper Agent, which is a tree that doesn't isn't class specific. There's a racial tree. We have different abilities there, which is sorely lacking in Sword Coast Legends. So yeah, DDO is up to 6 players for normal quests and 12 players for raids. Sword Coast Legends is 4 players. Maximum. Both of them have a hireling equivalent. You can fill in some spots with hirelings, but obviously those of us who play DDO are going to be biased towards DDO and recommend that you at least download it and try it out. But no, there is no Ravenloft yet. There is some Forgotten Realms stuff. It's mostly Eberron. But yeah, I would highly recommend, if you're interested at all, is, you know, DDO.com. Go there, download, try it, see what you think. And you haven't lost any money if you do that. So it's worth at least trying. The other thing I'll say is you might want to read up on some things, depending how familiar you are with Dungeons & Dragons in general. But the way DDO works, it might be worth looking up a basic like barbarian build or something to get started with, and try different servers. Different servers are active at different times of the day. Usually the community is pretty good, and you'll find some helpful people. Try to get into a guild and with some people who play during the times that you play, and the best way to do that is to go on the different servers at the time you play and just see if you can get in groups. There's a nice group panel where you can see all the open quests and the ones you're currently in level range to run. Speaking of that, subversions, oh yeah, I'm not gonna go into that, but so yeah, there's lots of fun things about DDO. It's not necessarily new player friendly. It can be kind of deep to get to through everything, but it's fun in the end. I do enjoy it. I've logged I don't know how many hours in it. And, it's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. The only MMO I really play. Okay, let's see. We have 12 and Kaneth. Let's go 12. I'll do the 12 one next. Save the Kaneth one for last. I'm not sure I'll survive this slot, but we can try. this is a secure storage area, right? Yeah, you can see my bravery streak here is 9, where it used to be a lot higher. But, yeah, things happened. Basically, I was half asleep and wasn't paying attention. And, lost my bravery streak, which was annoying. But yeah, there's a core of streamers who stream DDO, and there's lots of... There's a podcast and lots of sites and... Yeah. Another good point from Draculetta. DDO is based off 3.5. Circus Legends is based off of 5th edition. And they're based off of, in the same way that movies are based off of books. So there's a lot of differences, but the core rule set is trying to be mostly that edition that they're off of. I completely disliked Neverwinter. Both myself and my significant other play DDO, and we just looked at Neverwinter and went, yeah, no. Oh, thank you. Did I even buff? Oh, it looks like you did. Okay. Of course, water's the toughest for me. That cold damage, man. What else can I do to knock you down faster? Oh my. Jeez. I played the first Dragon Age and thought it was okay. Oh, the non-MMO Neverwinter, not the new Neverwinter MMO thing. Or whatever the new thing is called. Then that's different. I don't like old Baldur's Gate. I know a lot of people like Baldur's Gate, and I don't like those games, the Baldur's Gate that I've played back when. So those style games. I did like the old Gold Box games, though. Like Pool of Radiance and Azure Bonds and all that stuff was... Yeah. There's lots to do, lots of replayability and remixability in DDO that keeps a lot of people playing. And it continues to be updated, so there's always new stuff, and classes are changing and rebalancing, and new abilities, and new gear, and new quests, and all sorts of fun stuff. And you can play completely for free. Everything in the game is available by playing for free. Now, in reality, you're probably going to want to spend some money if you get into playing to get some benefit and get things a little more quickly, but you could play entirely for free if you wanted to. I need an elemental killer weapon. I'm just not doing enough damage against them. Not at all. Especially close range against a champion air elemental that's going to keep knocking me down. That's going to be fun. Really just not doing hardly any damage. Oop. Yeah, I'm soloing at the moment because I don't feel like looking for a group. I just want to get through some quests and get my... basically finish off the level 13 quests and get to take a level. I'm trying to do that. DDO has reincarnation, so to get more powerful, you take your character to cap and then start over from level 1. And every time you do that, you get some abilities that you can't get any other way, which is interesting. But yeah, you can play with people or not, depending on how powerful you are. I'm soloing heroic elite quests, which on this particular character aren't too difficult if I pay attention. Well, hope you enjoy it. Look forward to seeing you back on this or other streams to get some gameplay hints or tips or whatever you feel like. This is the official channel. For DDO streams, but it's mostly a bunch of regular players who stream on here. Hey, Retner, how you doing? I've got some past lives to give me extra hit points and such, so. Also depends on what class you are and all that. Yeah, Gemini, I agree. I really don't like fighting elementals at all. Even if they don't have that many hit points, they feel like they have a lot more hit points than they do because they're DR. It's just yawn fest. In case of air elementals, it's okay, get up, hit them again. Case of water elementals. Oh, look, I caught a bad polar ray that got hurt pretty bad, so I gotta heal. And otherwise, just sit here and whack them until they die. Not the most fun enemies to fight. Yeah, the earth elementals do have the nice sounds, at least. Make you feel like you're at least getting something done. Instead of whooshing, missing. I thought I was on the other quest. I thought I was in the House C when I'm not. Oh, hello everybody. How are you all doing today? Can we all get grouped up so I can mass kill you? That'd be awesome. Turn my ability off. There we go. For more healing. This is the part where I have to pay attention. Until I get these guys with them down to. Okay. Now I'm better. Yep. That's one of the reasons I miss being a warlock. Other than that, I basically play the same way, except I didn't have this button that does a lot of damage to most mobs. Whatever that ability is. And now I'm getting these free stuns, which is nice. What is that ability on for? Holy Retribution. Alright, Cordovan. Thanks. See you tomorrow for your stream. Should be able to watch it from work. Character stack, this guy's dead. I really shouldn't use that, I only got one left. Actually, let's go ahead and rest here. That way I'll have more. And I didn't do the thing. No magic. It's unfortunate. I once played. What were we doing? Man, I don't even remember what quest we were doing. But we were doing Epic Elites. I think we were doing the Vaughn chain. And there was a wizard that was in the group that had 100 hit points at level 21, maybe. And that was doing it wrong. You don't want to be playing Epic Elites and having only 100 hit points, because he was dying in one shot fairly consistently. Like every time somebody rezzed him. Like, you know, you're just draining our resources. This is not good. So I think the party leader eventually kicked him. Because, what the heck, you know? That's just not a good build. Yeah, where am I? Oh, I got that already. Yeah, he thought it was, and he must have. How do you even get 100 hit points at level 20 something? You've got to like work at it. You got to seriously just say, "Ah, con, no one needs con," and just not even put anything into it. Not have an item, not have a false life item. Just completely ignore the fact that, you know, con's your life. Your hit points are your life, and if you don't have hit points, you're dead. So yeah, you need them. Yeah, there's a challenge for somebody who wants a build challenge. Play only on elite. Permadeath. With a character that maxes out 100 hit points. And that's your absolute maximum for hit points. You cannot go above 100. Let's see how that works. Concentration checks. I don't mean heroic elites because that's not really that big a deal, but only 100 hit points in epic elite, there's a challenge for you. And solo everything too, yeah, there we go. Just to make it ultra fun. There's plenty of ways to increase the challenge in this game. In fact, I'd probably give 500 turbine points to somebody who does that and videotapes the, YouTubes it or Twitches the entire thing. From Korthos to everything. Oh, let's just add to the fun. Every quest in the game on Elite. Both at Heroic Elite and Epic Elite were available. Yeah. I mean, yeah, if you want to increase the challenge, no higher, no pots, no scrolls, no wands. No toughness. I mean, like, I have the auto heals now from the past life, epic past lives, so I could get by in some cases with that. I have to be a lot more careful than I'm being in any of this stuff today. I'd have to actually slow down and pull stuff. But nothing wrong with that. If you want to play hard and have higher, just have. Play on hard and have hires. I think that's what I like about DDO is you can play however you want to play. Don't bother me, man. That's one of the reasons I like playing Epic better is that I don't have to play on the hard difficulties in Epic to get a good amount of XP. Our barbarian sounds fun. Yeah, naked run, no items at all. Yep. I mean, DDO is just so flexible. There's so many ways to play and so many things you can do. So many different ways to create the same basic character. Yeah. That's something. Animation speed makes a big difference. Yeah, remember to hit that. I much prefer playing in epics, and I'm just really not liking these heroic levels on any of the builds I've done. I mean, obviously I enjoyed the warlock build, the blade lock, or Jotman's porcupine build that I was playing before this. I still enjoyed that, playing that particular build. I still don't enjoy being in heroics, though. It's just not my thing. I'd much rather be in epics. It's weird how much of a difference that makes, but it's true. And I've gotten more used to doing Giant Hold because really, in Heroics, you pretty much have to play Giant Hold. And I'm really worried about what my next build's gonna be, because I don't know what's gonna be different enough from this that I'm gonna be having fun with it, because I'm really not enjoying this Paladin build. It's just not that great. I like the survivability, I like the self-healing. But I really don't care for a lot of the Paladin abilities. It doesn't play... Even though I'm basically playing it like a Barbarian or Fighter, I'm just walking up and smacking stuff and occasionally self-healing. Just, meh. Oh, what a jerk. Destroy my spell components. Am I out of arrows? Must be out of arrows. This is Subversion, one of the newer quests from the Gatekeeper's Chain. That was what, last update? Can use a shield as your primary. There's a fun idea. You can't dual equip shields, can you? Because that'd be hilarious. Shield bashing, dual wielding shields. Line up so I can do that. Doesn't work as well on humans. It's unfortunate. That's a hilarious image to me. Like, be a monk wielding. Need two bucklers or something. You have your hand wraps through the handhold of the shield and stuff. Yeah, that'd be hilarious. I think that's something everybody can appreciate. The image of a guy running around with this shield in each hand, doing damage with him. I need to get back to my sorcerer, my bard, my rogue. I went ahead and reincarnated everything that was at cap, and haven't played him since. Because again, I just don't like your rogue that much. Once I get into epic, I'm much happier. Which means I haven't played all the new stuff because I haven't really had a character in Epics to play any of it. Although maybe tomorrow on my channel, going to play. Sounds like we're on with the Caineth group, at least Queen and I. I'm not sure about Skunk. Where is that other? There it is. Oh, these jerks. Wow. It's a bit of incoming damage. Oh, I see. Champion, I wish I. Everybody else is dead, though. Yeah, probably. Now, somebody get on that. Make that a suggestion to the DDO forums. We need dual-wielding shield. I don't care what class you have to make, what race, whatever. Just give me dual shield. Because that would be so much hilarity. I can't remember what level we're at on Kane. I think we're like 25. Which, I don't know, could be enough to. Oh, seriously? You guys? I think there's a shrine coming up where I can refresh my stuff. I have the optional salamander. My shoulder's really starting to hurt because my wrist hurts and I have my wrist brace on. And I just can't sit right, can't mouse right like this. So after that next quest, I'll probably call it over this one. Is it versions? No, there's still the Caineth one, whatever that one's called. I guess I'll try to do the Caineth one. I might try to take my wrist brace off here in a second. See if that helps. I have no idea about server full messages on Argo. You could ask Gemini since he plays on Argo. I mean, people petitioned long enough that they got gnomes coming in the next update, supposedly. And we're supposed to have, what, a patch this week? Something? I don't know. I haven't really been keeping up too much. Please don't aggro everybody in the room. Alright, I'm gonna take this stupid brace off. Oh, I hope that helped my shoulder. It's gonna be easier for me to do this. Hey Titan, how's it going? The patch is tomorrow, that's cool. Of course, we aggroed everybody. Hope we didn't aggro any finger jigs. That's gonna be awkward. We had a nice work lunch. Our team went out. Went to a little bit uppity, not horribly upscale. Place and got some nice barbecue for lunch. That was cool. Yeah, I don't understand the gnome thing myself, but evident people wanted them and they got them. So, yay. I should probably make sure I've got resistant energy fire on before I do this part. I don't have to do this part, but I kind of want to. Let's see how he's. Let's see if I can pull one. Nope. Dracula Dead and Loving It. That must be it. That must be the one you're talking about. Which I actually have not seen. I heard it was pretty bad. So you watched Lopeta Castle in the Sky over the weekend? And this weekend we're going to go see Totoro in the theater. So that'll be fun. Oh, I gotta give that. Does that even work? Can I really use a great axe on my rogue to assassinate with? That'd be hilarious. That would be so funny. So I really don't know my way around this maze. I got completely confused last time I was in here and had no idea what I was doing. I'm supposed to go up somewhere. I'm finding my way back out. Yep. Now, a bow makes sense to me. But the image of somebody sneaking up on somebody with a great axe and stabbing the heck out of them for a one-shot kill is just hilarious to me. Ah, there we go. That's what I was missing. Wasn't it? Yes, there it is. Okay. Yeah. Exactly. In full plate. You can just see a dwarven rogue in full plate and with his great axe. Creeping along behind somebody with his axe, and yeah. Maul would be hilarious too. Yeah. Slides into the floor, uncovering a hidden passage. Just that's an amusing mental image. Oh, hey guys, what's up? Oh shoot! Yeah, I think some buffs wore off or something. Wow. There. No, it's not. Vulpal Great Axe just means you can walk up to somebody and if you critical them, their head flies off. That's what Vorpal means. It's not the same thing as assassinating with a great axe. Like backstabbing with a great axe, basically. There we go. Elven Grace dex damage on a falchion. I have no idea. So I'm at the point where, let's see. Oh, there we go. Cutting guys out. I think my buffs have worn off. Let's do that. I know, excuse me, I know this last bit. Excuse me, let me mute real quick. There we go. Am I supposed to clear that out? Oops. Oh, well. I know this last fight can be a killer, so what I'm trying to do is make this pre-shrine last. No, there's no shrine. Maybe there is, and I'm just being too careful. Oh. It actually didn't use lay on hands there. Which I do like, lay on hands is pretty much instant, so that's your oh crap button. So, okay. Either I'm out of spell points or I took too much damage too fast and I can't wait for Community of Scribing to work, so let's just lay on hands real quick. I shouldn't go into this room, because I know what's in this room. I do know what is in this room. And this is a horrible idea. But... if you look at the chests in the right way until you see the one... there we go. That is not like the others. And in theory, you should be able to get out of here before you get slimeballed by them all. I don't think they'll go this far. They might. I'd hope they don't get up, come out here. Alright, that's the end. I need a shrine forged. For definite sure, because I need to have my stronger attacks back. Those guys are still trying to hit me. Sucks to be them. And I love assassinating on my rogue. It's a lot of fun. Alright, let's get the easy ones out of the way. And then let's see, get that one. Do the fire and the sonic. I think we're going to go ahead and put all the enhancements on for this next part. Or, all the buffs is what I meant. Yeah, there are some quests like that. I go from one enemy to orange alert. Nothing flat. I really need quicken for the heals. Holy crap, they're hitting me fast. I need to get up, need to get up, need to get up, need to get up, need to get up. Man, that's hard. I don't think I've ever tried to solo this. that level like this. So in theory, that'll give me a little bit of breathing room to hit this guy harder without all the incoming damage. My last play on hand was not. Or come on, get it, get it. Oh, shoot. Not paying attention to my health. I'm trying to get the last damage on him. Yes, got him. Let's see if I can survive the rest of them. Wow, they have got me pretty well locked there. Champions, no, I'm gonna die, that's fine. Anyway, I completed it. That was an important part. Which was a near thing. I almost died several times before I did that. So, yeah. But, completed. Took me longer than I thought it would. No end chest, oh well. Let's get some repairs. If I would have thought to actually use displays, that would have helped. See, I have click keys, I just forget to use them. See, there it is. The plus five, you can't see it because my green steel. There we go. Plus five great axe of assassinate. That's why I was laughing at the whole image of a dwarf rogue using a great axe to assassinate somebody. Sneaking up behind them and camming in the back with that, because that's just a hilarious image. Don't need those. Void lore and corrosion and illusion resistance. That's an interesting combination. Sell that for now. Yeah, I keep getting hand reps of double shot. I've seen a lot of those. Kind of funny. I need to go Hall of Heroes. No? I need to go 12. I need to turn that one in before I forget. And I've seen the leather armor of repair lore, which I understand has a very narrow, useful purpose, but beyond that, if you're Warforged, you use docents, not leather armor. So it still doesn't make any sense, even though if you use one of the new feats, you can transform yourself into a Warforged, basically. Corrosive magnetism. Daunting accuracy. Resilient fortification. Just take Tales of Valor. Alright, now we go back to the Hall of Heroes. Actually, I can just go to House C. I think I remember where it is. And I need to go to the bottom of my airship and remember to... I'm just going to buy those stupid things. Let's turn the things on for a minute. Yeah, see, 2 weeks, 6 days, 2 weeks, 6 days, 2 weeks, 6 days, and then no. So I've got electric, cold, and acid. I need fire and sonic. Greater Fire and Greater Sonic. Just to get these set up so I don't have to worry about them. Alright, now. 2 weeks, 2 weeks, 2 weeks. There we go. That's better. Oops. Didn't see I did that. I think of it as the random loop being like the schoolwork for the arties and such. It's like people who aren't very good are learning the trade and they create these really weird things. Like, oh, that wasn't what I was trying for. Oops. And they just sell it to like a, junk dealer. The junk dealer starts trying to peddle it to other people, and since he's... Oh, now I have to go back to get to the... Oh, that's annoying. To get to house C. Since he's a salesman, you know, he's able to sell it to people. They don't realize just how bad it is. So... Yeah. I need to go up, I think. Thought it was no. Over here, maybe. Where is it? Blown to bits isn't the one I want. Power play is not the one I want. Schemes of the enemy is not the one I want. Where is the stupid thing? Ah, it's right. But it's that right there. I thought it was up high, it's down low. Maybe, I don't know. There it is, multiple minutes. Do I have any challenges on here? No, because I reincarnated. I think I had some that I was close on, but you really just don't have enough. Well, you can get, if you have the character that's built to do it, you can get pretty close even if you don't five star. There is a build on the forums that I used. So first, let me throw this out there. I've got a bunch of little info on DDO, including my character list and stuff. But if you look at, here it is, the Challenge Farmer. And there's several variations of this. This is the Monk one that I used. Had a blast playing that character, by the way. I played it in a static group, and it was a blast. But it's really capable of doing most of the challenges solo. It's got really fast run speed, which helps a lot. It's got some self-healing, and it's got Detour, which helps a lot. There are things you can do to help yourself solo those reasonably well. Let me see if anybody's doing anything. Hey, look. 14 minutes in. Ah, what the heck. Hey, the Shacks, how's it going? I've seen you, been seeing you streaming DDO lately. Hope you're doing well this evening. Welcome. And as an aside, there's still plenty of room on the schedule for anybody who wants to stream on this channel. Contact Quartervent on the DDO forums if you're interested. We like the channel to be busy. So, yeah. The more people, the merrier. Oh, they're in the marketplace. That's okay. That's odd. Why is it showing that he's in if it's out anyway? I think he just realized and shut it down. All right. That's cool. Oh, Tempest Spine is fun. I haven't done the epic version or legendary version yet, but
Thundering
it is a
laughter
fun quest.
reverberates from behind this door. It sounds like Heratrachum's already found what he was looking for. A containment generator. Just what I need from a ritual. Come. Stay here and crush those callous idiot gadgeteers. Use the codex page I gave you.
Let's see how this goes. I did some soloing of Tempest Spine to farm my Cloak of Invisibility, but I was way over level, so it wasn't quite the same thing. Couple champion copies of himself. About that. Isn't. Oh, what's his name? Billbong 90. Isn't he in Australia? And he streams. You can stream on any connection that's relatively stable. But yeah, you have to way lower your stream quality. And you get lag spikes and stuff still. But it's doable. Maybe not greatest, but it's doable.
Says Carver. You help the devils, and we help the lords of dust. Very well, growls Rakshasa. But understand this. Once Eldericus conquers Shavaroth, he will help us free the Rajas from Kyber.
Plot. You know, I like the lot, the plot, but that it's there, but I don't really pay attention to it a lot of the time. Seriously, already? Alright, we just need to kill. Yeah, I saw you say that you were on a mobile connection, and I could not believe it. Because, wow. I couldn't do that. Reliably, and I can see the tower from my house, but for some reason the signal just isn't that great here. Yeah, you can look at, there's some guides online on how to stream on a really low bandwidth connection, and they guide you through what settings to use and all that, so you can still stream, but you don't. Obviously, it's not going to be as pretty, but you know, in some cases that's good because I've been watching a lot from my phone, and I put it in a mobile quality anyway, so the quality is horrible. Yeah, I know somebody, Mawful, isn't he? Mawful's from Sweden or something, and pays like, I don't know, $20 a month for a 100 connection, something ridiculous. So yeah, the country you're in and your available options for bandwidth have a lot to do with your streaming. I actually moved away from an area that just got Google Fiber like right after I left. I think my house would have been, that I had, would have been available for it. And it's 100-100. And it's also 100 bucks a month, but, you know. Lots of feed everything, I'm not sure. A relative is there and said something about you have to pay, like, for the first, you get a free install and you pay for the first 2 years and it's free after that for whatever level they're getting. So they're going for that because it's pretty cheap overall. I don't know if that's limited to something slower. But... ouch. That sounds horrible. I streamed on a laptop for quite a while before I got this desktop because I only had laptops for several years. Like, I don't know, about 10 years I was pretty much on laptops only. And I finally decided to go desktop and I got this widescreen, which is why you may notice some oddities with the stream. I know people have said they've noticed the different resolution. And at some point I'm going to upgrade my monitor. Hey City, how's it going? Glad you could make it tonight. Nice to see you. I'm upgrading my monitor resolution. I'm getting another ultra-wide monitor, basically. For gameplay, I'm going to use the current one for chat and such, maps, and, you know, that sort of thing, OBS. Yeah. That'll be fun once I get that, so I'll have two ultra-wides. See, that's a really good connection. I know, I had a friend and co-worker who lived out in the boonies, and all he could get was satellite. And he was trying to play WoW, I think, on satellite, and it just was not working well. Because his download was pretty good, but his upload was horrible. Because the way the satellite connection that he had worked was the upload was on a phone line. The download was satellite, and it was really fast, but the upload was on a phone line, it was really slow. Fine, you want attention, I'll give you attention. There you go. Yeah, I played on my 60-inch TV for a while. That was fun. I also played on my projector at... I don't know what it was. 72 inches, I think? Projector can go up to 120, but I was playing around 70-ish because of the way my room I was playing was laid out. I couldn't get it any larger. That was fun. And my layout is still TV ready. You can see that I have extra space along the sides and top where my bars are so that on a TV nothing gets cut off. Because that's a problem on a TV. Well, I'm playing on a 34-inch monitor at the moment, so... yeah, different ways to play and different devices. Just depends on what you want. Let's see. Okay, I should probably go this way with this one. I don't really know the order you're supposed to do this in. Just throw my phone away through it. Yeah, I find myself doing that sometimes, doing slash P or slash G. Or... Even when I'm in the thing and it doesn't matter. Let's see. All I need to worry about is those two. So that's done. Let's look at this one then. Yeah, Ranger's one of my possibles for my next life. Ah, spies. Love spies in the house. Love, can't wait to get an epic so I can run that. Such a fun quest. But I actually hated the first time I tried it. But after learning it, I really enjoy it. Yeah, I might follow Stream Tom's build.
Oh yeah,
City. I think everybody knows how much I love spies. I mean, if you've seen me play spies, you know that I love it. Because I say often enough that I love it. Yeah, Stream Tom, who streamed on here last night, had a interesting Ranger build that I might follow most of. Probably gonna tweak it. That's the fun thing about DDO. You find a build, then you tweak it to make it unique to you. I'm missing a lever or something somewhere, aren't I? So I got that lever. Everything else is. So like even though my character list shows that I use a build, it's not necessarily exact. Oh, this I'm thinking of the other one. I'm done here. I was thinking of that other one where you do the thing in the middle. Yeah, see, that's if you only use one character, you can advance and do a whole bunch of different stuff a lot differently than those of us who have real characters. You know, when you have characters, then yeah. Yep, it's fun to try different stuff. That's why I have alts. Because initially I didn't know what I wanted to play. This is my original character, and this is the character I've played the most and leveled the most and all that. But it's not my only character by far. Instead of reincarnating and trying a new build, I tried a new build. And some of that was, you know, for different playing with different people or being part of a guild or just wanting to run this or that. And so it was just to play around. But this is my main character. I kind of envy the people that only have one character because it's a lot cheaper. Because I've bought I don't know how many inventory space and bags and stuff for multiple characters and. If I had one character, I'd just do it for the one, and that would be it. Probably go ahead and buy those plus seven tomes if I only had one character. Because I know I get the use out of them. Actually, I'm pretty sure that plus eight tomes are coming out, and I'll wait for plus eights to go on sale. And then I might consider buying tomes. And yeah, I have different chest builds on other servers too when I ran out of character slots on Dahlonis. I went to other ones. And then I went ahead and made the same character on every server. So Simorgu exists on every server. And it is a Morning Lock on every server. Although I'll probably TR into a Blade Lock at some point for those. If I get into that. Kena's the only one I've really played a lot. And I've got a couple of other characters in Argo. I ran with Gemini a bit on Argo when he was doing a marathon. And just the other week, I hopped back on because he was in the right level range. So I did that because I wanted to be able to play with people on other servers who aren't on Hollis. And I also started the Not My Home Server Guild on all servers but Hollis. For the same reason, just to have something. I'm not. Camargo isn't necessarily a member of that one because I have been invited to other guilds and have done that, but it exists. Oh, hey dudes, what's up? How about most of you die? No, only about half. The way they've done them now, here I'll show you real quick on my character, is really nice. If you look in your feats, there's now special feats. If you hover over one, it tells you. Now, what it doesn't tell you is your maximum, which is something I would really like to have them fix. But right now I'm level 14 or 15. No, sorry, 16. So the highest is level 4 or level 15 plus 4 that applies. Even though I have. I don't know if I have a 4 or 5 on this particular stat. But you can see 3, 7, 11, 15, 19, 23, 27. There's room for a plus 8 at level 30. So I'm thinking that there will be plus 8 tomes in the near future. And I'm waiting for those because the upgrade cost from 7 to 8 is ridiculous compared to just buying plus 8s in the first place. But anyway, as you level, they will reapply at the right level. And that should happen for skill tomes as well. I know I have at least 2 plus 5s. What's really funny is my fate points apply instantly, which I can't use until I get an epics anyway. Yeah. My skill tomes, at least up to 3. I've got a 4 somewhere. I don't remember what I put 4 on. There we go, Haggle's a 4. So, up to plus 4 skills are happening. What am I doing? I'm unlocking this door, that's what I'm doing. Okay. Oh, I think it fixes the plus 1 drops, yeah. Which I've gotten, I think, 2 of. So I'm kind of annoyed because, of course, I have at least. I think plus 4 in every stat. I know I have at least plus 3, but I think I have plus 4. So I could have had something better than a plus 1 in the 2 tomes that I've gotten recently. But I don't because of that issue, which is really annoying. Come on. These jets last too long. No, they've changed that recently where you can apply them whenever and then they will take effect as you level, which is really nice. The plus 7 tomes were on sale, 20% off, just last week, I think. If you wanted plus 7 tomes, it's a really good deal to get 20% off of them. Because they're pretty expensive for the Supremes. Want it for every stat. And if you're going that way, you might as well just go ahead and do them all. I know some people have gotten from drops. One of my guildies has pulled, I think, 2 plus 6 or plus 7 tomes out of the gold dice daily roll for VIPs. I haven't seen one. I keep getting other junk, which is annoying because I would really like to have some nice tomes. That would be fun. But I think that sale's over with. I don't know. Maybe it doesn't. It's only Tuesday, so maybe not. I'll check here in a second. Yeah, if you're gonna go for buying tomes, I really would recommend just going for the top. Due to the way the prices work. Let's see. I can't really see the store in that corner. Let's move it out. Excuse me. Nope, they're still on there. So if you look, plus four, 7 times of stream ability is, of course, you have to be level 3 at least to use it, but because that's the minimum for tomes. But it's 20% off, so it's normally 5,445 points,
Oh
and it's
no,
currently
the Sawagin
4,356
found me.
points. Thank you for the follow, the Shacks. Appreciate that. So yeah, plus 7 tome for 1,100 turbine points off. I mean, it's really tempting to do. Really tempting. And the plus 6 is 200 turbine points cheaper. You might as well go for the plus 7 if you're doing that. But here's the key. So say you went for plus 6. Plus 6 is 4,116, right? And then later you decide, no, you know what? I really want plus 7. Then you play an extra 3,400, almost 3,500 turbine points for that plus 6 to plus 7 upgrade. You may as well just spend the 200 extra points and get the plus 7 in the first place. And I'm thinking the same thing applies to the plus 8s that I'm. This is me just speculating that are going to come out because level 30 makes sense to have plus 8s. And, yeah. So I'm going to wait to plus 8s. I may be waiting forever. I wouldn't hold your breath. But I may do that. And then if plus 8s come out, and then if they're on sale 20% off or 50% off, like that, what was it? Plus 6s were 50% off? Something was 50% off a while back, a month or so ago, for some of the holiday deals. But it wasn't the plus 7s, so this is a really good deal on plus 7 tomes. Of course, you know, it's a lot of money, so there is that too. If you don't have it, don't spend it. Yeah, I love Lars Hayden in his Sawagin found me, so that's, I got extracted that sound to use as my follower sound. It amuses me every time I hear it. The thing about having a lot of characters is that I went through Korthos a lot of times fairly quickly in a row, and that was the dialogue line that really stuck with me out of that whole experience. So hey, Vornami, how you doing? Yeah, there have been some other sales that are better than the current sales, but this is the first time I think plus sevens have been on sale, so yeah, there's that too. Wow, hey, so you got points to go for it. Most of my tomes have come from the card events and such, so I've got a full set of plus threes on several characters because of that. And then this particular character, I got the 5,000 favors, so I have a plus 5 tome from that. And then the others I've got were either drops or auction house or something. No, see, the problem with the Kobold Towns is that I burned myself out on the entire game by doing Crystal Cove, and I really don't need to hear the Kobold that often. I've been there, done that. I don't need to do it again. The Kobold Sounds, while amusing, are very annoying after a while. For some reason, Lars is just funny. Yeah, the couple breaks I've taken from the game have been, most of them have been after Cove, and because I ran Cove just so much. I just burned myself out of the entire game because I ran Cove so much. But that was when it was new. I took a 2-year break the last time I had a break, I think. And part of it was because of the Cove. Not gonna say the whole thing was Cove, because it was some life stuff happening and moving and whatnot, but Cove was definitely a contributor. Oh, the archers, so many archers. This is where I'd like to be a ranger and have good range, or at least a warlock. Some of these guys down, not worry about them as much. All right, I thought I was on the fragments, but okay, whichever. I'm gonna ignore those guys. Nope. I highly doubt they would do an engine day at this point. We're coming up, well, that's the other thing. I mean, 10-year anniversary is coming up for the game. And there's supposedly some really cool stuff planned. Some new cosmetic pets given away, and much stuff to do and whatnot. So, interesting to see what they do for that. Keeping it under wraps, mostly. But I would definitely say at some point there's going to be a significant enough decline that they're going to have to look at getting the game down to one server and then probably pulling the plug at some point. Which is unfortunate, because there's nothing quite like DDO. Here it is. This is the one I thought it was in before. Oh, did I forget to rebuff? I think I forgot to rebuff after that shrine. Hmm. Oops. I mean, just being realistic, it's gonna happen. Sad fate to contemplate, but it's definitely had a good run. I would have played it sooner had they not done the double dipping model at first. I don't play games where you have to buy it and you have to pay a subscription fee. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're not going to sell it. I'm pretty sure they can't sell it. Because of their, they only have a license to, for them to run it. And you can't take the DDO out of the game, really, without eviscerating it and starting over almost. So while it would be nice to have fan-run servers and that, I don't think it would happen. I still think the license would allow for it. Doesn't seem like the wizards would give up. Whoa, hello. Spike damage. Yeah, maybe someone else would do a DDO2, or maybe even WB/Turbine would do a DDO2 at some point, but I'm not hopeful. Not saying it won't happen, but I'm not hopeful about it. Oops. I always do that. Not always, but I say wait a minute of the time I do it. Oh, another foreign juggernaut. Speaking of which, I need to see how Shadowrun Online's doing. I haven't checked in on that since they supposedly went bankrupt, but the game is still going. They're still developing on it, which is weird. Such a disappointing launch. Disappointing game. No, it's not. But this is very much a old school player kind of game. It was very not newbie friendly. It still isn't that newbie friendly. There's still so much complexity in how everything works, and since everything keeps changing, you have to relearn how things work constantly. I'm not complaining about that, I'm just stating that that's how it is. And, you know. Hey Mari, how's it going? Glad you could stop by. Alright, so this is the point where we don't need that. That was just for the chest, I think. And that's what we really want. So now we can leave. Maybe? I don't remember. Oh, there's still another lever, isn't there? Yeah, there's some more guys to kill. Awesome. It's awesome when people can run together. That's why I have characters in every server, because I want to be able to run with everybody at some point. My goal would be eventually to have a capped character in every server where I can. That's flagged for everything, so I can just hop in whatever's going on. In theory. Obviously, that doesn't always work. Due to level differences and stuff, but. The idea is that I would be able to experience playing with everybody on their home server. That's one thing I don't like about MMOs in general, is the multiple server thing. I would definitely like to be able to play with everybody. I remember back when I first started playing, which isn't nearly as long as a lot of people. Sometime after I went free to play is when I started playing, but there were so many LFMs up. There were so many instances of Marketplace and Harbor and stuff people were in. There was just so much, and LFMs filled so quickly that you had to pretty much jump on them if you saw them. You could literally pull up the LFM, look at it, and then it'd be gone by the time you said, oh yeah, that's what I want to do. Whereas anymore, it's once in a while that happens, at least on most of the servers I've played on. But usually there aren't that many. And then there's Wayfinder where there's hardly any. But I would like to see a return of more things. And I think Cordovan addressed some of the problems they have, technically, that they have to figure out how to solve. In, what was that? Last Friday's at 4 last week. Which, by the way, this week is Fridays at 5, if you guys didn't catch that, starting an hour later. So we can attend corporate things on Fridays that happen at 4. But, you know, they have the whole, what happens to your airship, what happens to your guild level, what happens to your character slots. There's a whole bunch of things that they have to think about and be careful to try to preserve when they do something like a server merge. Which, you know, makes sense. It's not insurmountable, but it makes sense that they're considering that stuff and they want to do it right. And I agree with that approach in general. The problem I have with that is and a lot of the things that they say around that same topic is that, okay, so when can you devote time to it? And the answer is, well, we can't. We've got the next updates to happen, we've got these bug fixes to do, we've got this and that to go on. And I understand that a lot of the stuff, like, I personally, what I would like to see is a major UI overhaul. That would be the most wonderful thing, as far as I'm concerned, to happen. I don't care about more content or more raids. I don't care about fixing things like the ladder bug that have been around forever. I don't really care about balance issues as much. I really wanted to see a huge UI upgrade. That would be the best thing, in my eyes, that could be done to the game to help it ease some day-to-day pain. And guild management is part of that. Although I don't think the guild management is horrible as it is for the guilds that I've been in. I understand in larger, more active guilds it might be. I've tended to be in smaller guilds and they're less active, so it hasn't been a big deal. Either you trust everybody or you don't, basically. So, not a big deal. But I understand in some guilds it's you need those more granular levels and you need some more things to do and different ways to do stuff that makes more sense for a larger guild. But just, I mean, little things like right here. This icon for Elixir of Greater Healing. Why is the fact that it's a potion the biggest thing about that icon? the fact that it's a potion would be the smallest thing about that icon. I don't care that it's a potion. What I care about is what the effect is. The effect should be the largest element on that button, not the smallest. You know, just things like that. There's a whole bunch of things about the character sheet that I'd like to have fixed. I'd like everything to be accurate. I would like to be able to export my combat logs, my character setups and builds and stuff. There's a whole bunch of things I'd like to happen. That for me are personally higher priority than a lot of stuff. Come on, jerk, stop throwing it at something that I mean come get killed. So then I would like to see more stuff that's existing be epified, so there's more familiar epic content, and then I'd love to see the end game, the last biggest, hardest raid in the game be Korthos. And it'd be cr just soul-crushingly difficult at the current level 30 with all past lives and everything power level. I would like it to require 12 people to cooperate very specifically in specific ways to get through it, and just be not be possible otherwise. Talking about Legendary Elite, I want, you know, mobs to be level CR 100 plus, just as difficult as you can get it, so that there's something to work towards, and that we have things where we once again have to group up for. Oh, Notorious GIMP, how's it going, bud? Haven't seen you streaming as much lately. But welcome. Glad you could stop by. It was too elite in chat. We needed somebody to bring it down the level. You missed me dying at the end of Subversion. I got mobbed by Slod. Was glorious, and I still won. Yeah. I know, it seems like after the holidays it's been worse than the holidays themselves for some reason. Just haven't been able to catch up on anything. That's cool. New people streaming though, so that's cool. Yeah. I mean, we still have cleaning to do that we didn't get done because our relatives that were coming out didn't end up coming out. So we didn't do it all, end up doing all the cleaning we were gonna do. And just haven't gotten around to it. Just have all sorts of other stuff going on. The SO's back to working 10-hour days for no apparent reason, because it's slow for retail kind of places, but I don't know. Oh, he's lobbing. Look at. He's lobbing stuff from way over there, and it's hitting me, interrupting my recall. What a jerk. Yes, I want to recall. I missed my detour from my warlock. Yeah, I'm out of sorts. Oh, look, these jerks. Seriously, you guys, stop. Oh, I actually came home from work and took a nap before the stream. I was just out of it. Okay, so that's done. So where does that put us as far as all this stuff? All right, Mari, night, sleep well. Thanks for stopping by. See you next time. Okay, so of the 14s that I'm actually going to do, the only one that's really left is Crucible. And there's no Crucible up, so I'm not going to do it. So I'm pretty sure that's going to call it for the stream today. Yeah, so I'm basically level 17. I just need to do Crucible, and then I'll take 17. And then continue the grind. And it's a real grind until I get an Epics. Once I hit Epics, it's a lot more fun. But this heroic stuff, I just. Such a grind. I may actually go from level 1 just for some variety, so I have to start with Lords March and Giant Hold. Oh, if only there was an instant replay that shows up as soon as I stop streaming, or that I upload on YouTube later, where you could catch all the action that you missed. That would be awesome. I don't even feel like dealing with this stuff right now. Did I get any favor or anything? Nope. All right, so that will be it for me today. I do want to say, boy, I can't even type. Thanks to everyone stopping by today. Good chatting. Nice interactivity and all that. Oh, Rat Cam went dark. Forgot about that. Just gonna turn a light on for that. Rothko, Big Sugar. Thank you, thank you. If you want more of me, I will be on probably tomorrow evening around the same time on Caneth doing Zerg Show prep, which is still going to be coming at some point. Maybe later than expected due to real life. But it should be coming at some point. We're still prepping for it. But my own channel, that'll be on that. I upload pretty much everything I do onto YouTube. I'm available on Twitter, my own website, and Steam, of course. Are damsels on or off tonight? I don't remember. And then tomorrow, of course, Cordovan with the weekly Wednesday Lunchtime live stream and all that fun stuff. So, thanks all, and good night. See you next week, if not before.